The discretionary retail sector is seen by many as a bellwether for consumer sentiment. But that also means it can be more sensitive than most to changes in exchange rates, online competition and consumer spending. Despite this, JB Hi-Fi remains strong against a challenging backdrop. Chief Executive Richard Murray joins us now. Richard, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Most discount retail businesses run on tight margins, but JB has performed well. Why is this?
Well, I guess we have globally the best cost of doing business in the consumer electronics industry, and we're really proud of that. It's obviously driven by the fact that we sell a lot of things, so we have a good sales number. But really, what the low cost of doing business enables us to do is stay on the money on price. I think also just great people in the stores. So if you come in and you get a great experience and a great price, that's a pretty good head start.
And you've been clear about the need to expand the number of shop fronts. How do you see that progressing?
Yeah, I mean, we're at 194 and our stated target is 214. So we are later in the rollout. Really where I think about the future is trying to get the stores and online to work together. So I want a customer who starts their journey at home on the computer and then comes into store. We need to make sure that we find ways to engage with them sort of seamlessly. That said, if you're in store and you want to complete the purchase online, we need to do a better job in the future of how we do that.
And how are you looking to continue to grow online sales?
So I'm probably not as worried about growing absolute online sales as I am about delighting a customer in-store or online and however a customer wants to shop with us. So we've got a new CIO who's working on a bunch of IT projects. We've just recently recruited a strategy director. And really the whole executive team is not so much focused on online, but we're focused on our customers. And a key way to engage with our customers is online.
There's been an influx of international retailers into the Australian market. How do you see this impacting the business?
Most of the international retailers that come to Australia have been more fast fashion. So to date, I guess we haven't really had much of a change in our competitive landscape. Obviously, we've had a competitor leave the market. And so really for us over the next sort of 12 months, we're really focused on making sure that, you know, some of the customers that shopped with Dick Smith who now don't have that opportunity, that we show them that, you know, JB's a great place for them to shop in the future.
Richard Murray, thank you for your time.
Thanks very much.